What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. So I just finished watching episode 3 of season 2 of The Boys. This particular episode is probably the grossest episode that I have experienced. And it wasn't that it was so much a lot of gruesome stuff. It was just one particular part that just grossed me out. But let's start with this SOB Homelander, okay? You guys have seen me do reactions to the gamer Patchouli, and you have seen what he does to his little dummy Steve. That's what I want to do to Homelander. That's what I want to do to Homelander every single time I see his face. Oh, I can't stand him. So let's start by him being still all up in his kid's face. I don't even want him to be part of his life. And I'm not even like that in real life. But just off of this show, like, he's really trying to push him to be just like him to the point where he took him on the roof of the house. First of all, it's bothered me so much that he was sitting there getting served breakfast. Like, nobody even invited you to the table. You just appear there wherever you feel like it. But he took his son up on the roof and was trying to get him to fly and then pushed him off. That made me so mad. That made me so mad, y'all. Oh my gosh. And then we saw the kid get really angry and he pushed Homelander down. Like, cause he grabbed, what's her name? I keep forgetting Butcher's wife's name, but the kid's mom. He grabbed her by the arm and tried to threaten her, and he like, his eyes turned red and the kid pushed him really, really hard. And he was like, I hate you. I don't ever want to see you. And, you know, like he really hates him. And I'm like, good job. Good. Good. I don't even want him near the kid. So now, let's see. I'm probably going to be all over the place. Sorry, y'all. A-Train, something is still wrong with him, clearly. Like, he can't run too fast without him feeling like something's still wrong with his heart. Like, I don't know what happened between us seeing him laying in that bed with tubes and then he popped up at the interview where Starlight was at. Like, I don't know how he got out of that. I don't know what happened. I don't know if he took a dose of Compound V. I don't know, but he still got problems with his heart because he can't go too much without something going on. And we see that throughout the episode. Huey just can't catch a freaking break. Poor Huey. I just feel bad for him. Something or someone is always blowing up around him. He's always covered in something or someone's guts. It was just so horrible. So apparently the Deep is kind of getting back or trying to get back into the Seven, right? So now Butcher and the crew are out on sea. They've got Kimiko's brother. He tries to escape. It didn't work. They're on this boat. The FBI comes on a helicopter. The brother gets pissed. He dismantles the helicopter. So now they have to go to this CIA hideout. While they're on this boat, they're making their way. And all of a sudden, you see, like, a whole bunch of fins. They look like shark fins. And I'm like, what are these, like, souped up sharks? So they're hitting the boat and everything. The boat's going crazy. And now they got to get off the boat. They got to go into the little boat. And they're on there and they see the opening to the little CIA hideaway type of thing. And lo and behold, it's the Deep with his sea friends. And he's in front of this the CIA opening that they're supposed to be getting into. And they're telling him to move and he's not moving. And the boat is going at full speed. And this boat literally crashes right into what looks like a whale. It was so disgusting. They literally went into, like, they crashed into this whale. And it was so, it made me gag. It was so disgusting. I think that was the most disgusted I felt watching something in this series so far. Okay, it was just so nasty. Huey, poor Huey, he left Starlight a message while he was on the boat. Now he's inside the whale, guts, blood all over him. And Butcher's trying to get him out. He's like, no, I'm going to stay right here. I'm going to wait for my second wind. Excuse me? Huey is literally falling apart at this point. I feel so bad for him. So then MM comes and he kind of sits with him and it makes him come out of the whale. I know that sounds really nasty. Freaking Homelander. First of all, the seven show up. The seven, right? And what's her face? Storm. I'm just going to call her Storm because I forgot her full name. But anyway, Storm is like, she's almost kind of up there bossy with Homelander. So, you know, she's talking to the Deep and she says something. I forgot what she said, but it made Homelander look at her with a side eye. Like, what do you think you're doing? Like, I'm running this, you know? Homelander looks at the Deep and y'all know the last episode he was having self-image issues and he's like, you ripped your, you know, your clothes or whatever. He's like, cover it up. It's disgusting. So now I'm like, oh my gosh, now he's going to get the Deep to go deep again into his feelings about his self-image, whatever. So now they're in this thing trying to figure out their way to whatever. I don't know if it's a bunker or the CIA, whatever it is, right? Starlight comes looking. They're all kind of looking for this crew. Nobody knows who it is. So Huey's walking all the way in the back. Like, he's kind of like really far from everybody. And he looks behind him and he sees that someone's after him. So he hides and it's Starlight. So he looks at Starlight. He was like, oh, you got my message. Before he could even finish that, she shut him up because she saw Homelander. So now Homelander is trying to make her kill him. And I'm just like, please don't do it. Please don't do it. Meanwhile, the crew is kind of turned back to kind of see what was going on. So they're watching this whole thing. So now Kimiko's brother is loose. Like, his hands are loose. So she's starting up with her, you know, Starlight thing that she does. And Butcher saves him. They're on the boat, by the way, while they're on the boat. Huey punches him and then just kind of wants to let off on him and just kind of starts fighting him or whatever, or is trying to. But now the Butcher saves his life by getting Kimiko's brother to literally like cave in whatever road or whatever was above them onto Homelander. So then finally they escape out of there, but then the brother escapes and now so does Kimiko. So she's running after him and he's trying to run and she's trying to save him and he just doesn't want to be saved. Long story short, here comes Storm acting like freaking Homelander. Like, she doesn't even care who she hits. She's throwing them through these apartments. She's throwing the people in the apartments around. She's going floor by floor, just exploding everything. She just does not care. So finally they get up to the roof. She catches up to them. They're trying to jump over the building. Kimiko stays behind because she catches Kimiko. So the brother comes back to try to fight her. She snaps his hands, both of them. And literally, like, she's like, look at me. I like to see the lights go out. Like, she is, I'm like, this chick is sick. I knew there was a reason why I didn't like her, but I didn't know she was this bad. So she snaps his neck. Kimiko sees all of this. So then Homelander shows up. And Homelander says to her, I told you he was mine. And she was like, you snooze, you lose. So he looked really pissed off. Like, I kind of thought that she kind of had a thing for him. But now I see that she might be up there with the evilness with Homelander. Maybe even more. Because she, like, gives zero Fs at all. Like, she does not care whatsoever. And she does not pretend to care. So I don't know who's... We're just now seeing a little bit of Storm, and we've seen already what Homelander is capable of, and I don't know. There might be some evil competition between the two of these. These two are just absolutely sick, insane, and evil individuals, okay? Just crazy. So now it seems they're all watching the news. The big guy who took over, you know, Madeline's position or whatever, he's covering everything up by saying they were souped up terrorists that, you know, tore this up. And if it wasn't for Storm, she kind of saved the day. And, you know, it looked like they're in this like soup kitchen kind of place where they're, you know, helping people, less fortunate people. And you see Homelander kind of looking at them sideways. And she gets up to the mic and she turns around and she's clapping and she's smirking at him. And I'm just like, oh, he's out for blood. And you see Kimiko sitting where they are. And she's looking at this through the screen and she's out for blood. And I'm like, oh my God. So this seems to be getting a bit crazier, especially with Homelander and Storm being as evil as they are. Now they look like they're about to be in competition with each other, which screams disaster. But that's just my opinion. We're going to have to see what happens on the next episode. But in the meantime, leave your comments down below. Let me know what you guys think of episode 3, season 2 of The Boys. Let me know what you guys think of my review. If you haven't done so, subscribe to my channel, hit like, share, and don't forget to hit the notification bell so you guys can get notified whenever I pop up on your feed. I'll see you guys later.